Hari Chemistry. So the topic is Rutherford's alpha particle scattering experiment or Rutherford's gold foil alpha scattering experiment or planetary model, or we can call it as Rutherford's model of an atom. Okay, so here before the J.J. Thomson atomic model, so it is not accurate. So then later, so Rutherford's proposed is a model of an atom. So here, so video's content. So please subscribe my channel. Thank you. So the topic is Rutherford's alpha particle scattering experiment, or we can call it as Rutherford's gold foil alpha particle experiment, or planetary model, or Rutherford's model of an atom. Okay, so clear student, right here. So you can see this is the setup for the Rutherford's alpha particle scattering experiment. Here, so it is a large circular screen. So here, so this large circular screen is coated with the phosphorescent material. So such as we are using zinc sulfide screen we are using. Okay, so here, so in this large circular screen, he kept a very thin gold foil inside this large circular screen. Okay, it is a very thin plate, so used for this experiment process. And here, so this is a lead plate, and here, so this is the source of alpha particles here, which produce alpha particle with He+2. So here these are the positively charged particles. So this is the setup for the Rutherford experiment process, and so the whole process he has done in the dark room. Okay, so he done his experiment in the dark room. Okay, so what he observed during the experiment process. Okay, right, so this is the alpha particle source. So alpha particle source means nothing but, so just like we can imagine, so it emits the alpha particle. So this source, it can emit the alpha particle, like when the bullet is comes from the gun. Here also same, the alpha particles are emits, and so these alpha particles are moved through the lead plate and hit the gold foil, then hit the large circular screen. So what will happen in this screen when these alpha particles are emits from this alpha particle source? So these alpha particles are hit the gold foil, and then so these alpha particles are hit the large circular screen. When so these alpha particles are hit the large circular screen, then it gives a glow, so a bright light is occurs during these scattering process. Okay, so what he said, that the most of the alpha particle, the first point what he observed during this experiment, most of the alpha particles, most of the alpha particles are passed through the gold foil without deflecting, means there is no bending. So undeflected. But here, so we can see the, according to the J.J. Thomson atomic model, what he said, that the positive charge is uniformly distributed in the atom. But if the positive charge is uniformly distributed in the atom, when these alpha particles are collide with the positive charged particle, so these positive repulse will be happen. So if these positive repulsion, then the alpha particle can change the direction. But here it is not happening, because the most of the alpha particles are passed through the gold foil and in straight line and without deflecting. So here this is the observed the first thing. The second point, a small number of alpha particles hit this gold foil, and so a small number of alpha particles are deflected with a small angle deviation. So here, a small number of alpha particles are are deflected in small angle deviation. Small angle deviation. A small number of alpha particles are deflecting. So here, a small number of alpha particles are change their direction. So here, a small number of alpha particles are change their direction. A small number of alpha particles are change their direction. Clear, student? Right. So that the third point, what he observed, that is, so very few alpha particles. So we can say that is 1 in 20,000. 1 in 20,000 alpha particles are strike the gold foil. 1 in 20,000. So alpha particles are strike the gold foil and so bounced back. So gold foil and bounced back. So means these alpha particles are return back to this direction. Bounced back again. So these, when these alpha particles are hit the gold foil and bounced back, and so these alpha particles are a large angle deviation is possible. Bounced back again and a large angle deviation that is nearly 180 degrees. So means here, so 100 and so the gold, these alpha particles are bounced back and hit the large circular screen with the angle of 180 degrees. So here also same. So the alpha particles are hit the gold foil and the alpha particles are bounced back, and so these alpha particles are hit the large circular screen at a certain point. So these the three things he observed during the experimental process. Okay, so these are the experimental process of Rutherford alpha particle scattering experiment. Okay, right. So what he concludes these points, what he concludes during these experimental observations. So the first point is more directly passed through the gold foil, so without undeflected. So that indicates that so most of the space inside the atom is empty. So that is the first conclusion. So most of the space inside the atom is empty. Clear? And the second point, so a small number of alpha particles are deflected from their path. So only a small number of alpha particles are deflected from their path. So this point what indicates that a positive charge occupies very little space inside the atom of at the center. So means here the positive charge, when these alpha particles are hit the positive charge, so then they change their direction from their path. So these two points he concludes during the experimental process. Then what are the postulates of Rutherford alpha scattering experiment? So the postulates of Rutherford alpha scattering experiment, the first postulate is what he said, that is the first point, the most of the space inside the atom is empty, and a positive charge is occupies very little space inside the atom at the center. So these positively charged particle inside the atom at the center he called as nucleus. So he said, so that is a nucleus. That is nucleus. That is the first postulate of Rutherford atomic model. And all the mass of the atom is present at the nucleus. All the mass of an atom, of all elements, are present in the nucleus of an atom. Then second point, the electrons are revolving around the nucleus. So the electrons are revolving around the nucleus, just like we can imagine the planets are revolving around the sun. So just like the planets are revolving around the sun. The third point is the charge of the nucleus is 10 to the power of minus 13 centimeter or So we can convert into meters, that is 10 to the power of minus 15 meter, or also we can called as, this is a Fermi unit. So the Fermi unit is the smallest unit in the measurement of distance, that is the small the range of the size of the nucleus is 10 to the power of minus 13 centimeter, or 10 to the power of minus 15 meter, or we can call it as one Fermi unit. Or the size of the, relatively, when we compare to the size of the nucleus is relatively very small. So that, because the size of the atom is 10 to the power of minus 8 centimeter, or 10 to the power of minus 10 meter. So here what he postulates, that the size of the nucleus is relatively small when compared to the size of the atom. So here the size of the nucleus is 10 to the power of minus 13 centimeter, or 10 to the power of minus 15 meter. Here the 10 to the power of minus 8 centimeter, or 10 to the power of minus 10 meter. So these are the postulates said during these Rutherford alpha scattering experiment or gold foil experiment. Okay, clear student? Right, then we will discuss the drawbacks of Rutherford alpha scattering experiment. Okay, clear student? Right, thank you. Rutherford atomic model. So the Rutherford atomic model could not explain the stability of an atom. So could not explain the stability of an atom. Could not explain the stability of an atom. So this is the drawback of Rutherford model of an atom. So here this is the nucleus. This is the nucleus. Okay, so here the electrons are revolving circular path. Revolving circular path. So this is the path of electron moving in this circular path. Okay, so here these electrons are negatively charged particles. So these negatively charged particles undergoing accelerated according to the Maxwell electromagnetic theory. So according to this theory, if any charged particle is in motion, the particle, it emits the energy or it absorbs the energy. Here also the same thing we can apply. So the electron is a charged particle. So it revolves in circular path undergoing acceleration. So here it circulars, it revolving in this circular path. If it emits the energy in the form of radiation continuously. If it emits the energy in the form of radiation. Okay, so it, when it emits the energy in the form of radiation continuously, at certain point, so the electron will lose its energy and the electron can be fall into the nucleus. If these electron can be fall into the nucleus, then the atom becomes highly unstable. But according to the Rutherford concept, the atom is stable. But why atom is stable? He could not explain Rutherford model of an atom. So that is the drawback of Rutherford atomic model. The second point, Rutherford atomic model could not explain the line spectrum of an atom. The third point is, if the electron lost its energy continuously,
the atomic spectra continuously, the atomic spectra will be continuous atomic spectra. The atomic spectra will be, it gives the continuous atomic spectra. Continuous atomic spectra. But the experimentally, atomic spectra is made up of discrete spectral line. So, but according to this drawback, if the electron is lost its energy continuously, then the atomic spectra will be continuous only. But as per experimental evidences, the atomic spectra is made up of discrete spectral lines. Atomic spectra is made up of discrete spectral lines. Discrete spectral lines. So these are the three drawbacks of Rutherford's atomic model. Okay, clear student? The first point is here. So he could not explain the stability of an atom. So here this is the electron. Electron is revolving in circular path, undergoing acceleration. According to the Maxwell electromagnetic theory, if any charged particle, here electron is the charged particle, if any charged particle is in motion, generally what will happen, it emits the energy or it absorbs the energy. The same manner here, if these electron revolving in circular path undergoing acceleration, so these electrons can emit the energy in the form of radiation. So it emits the energy continuously. At certain point it lost its energy, then the electron fall into the nucleus, then the atom becomes highly unstable, but the atom is stable in the matter. But he could not explain the stability of an atom. Clear? The second point is, he could not explain the line spectra of an atom. The third point is, if the electron lost its energy continuously, then the atomic spectra will be continuous. But as per the experimental evidences, the atomic spectra is made up of discrete spectral lines. Means discrete means nothing but separated lines, separated spectral lines. So these are the drawbacks of Rutherford's model of an atom. Okay.